Hello everybody, my name is Phaethodas and here we have one more new experimental build. This build is called Aura build because I was trying with this build to see if I could put together something that would actually allow my Ring of Flame Aura to kill enemies. Not only to deal damage but also kill enemies. And here we have it. This is an experimental build. It works but not so much. I mean, we kill enemies with or we deal a good amount of damage with this aura, but if we want to allow this aura to kill enemies, we will have to wait to be stationary, something like that, because it takes time to kill enemies, so it is not really that effective, legendary difficulty at least. to fix this problem, what can you do? We use a couple of other skills to help deal more damage to enemies. What is this build? This build is a conjurer. Conjurer is Earth Mastery and Spirit Mastery. On this build, I have about half of my attribute points to strength and half to dexterity, nothing else. It is strength, dexterity. Here we can see that we have more points than here, of course, because this is because a couple of items provide buffs to strength, big buffs to strength attribute, so we have these changes. But more or less, it is about the same. So, before we go to the items, this is the state of the skills. I have plus 4 to all skills. I wanted to have plus 4 to all skills, especially of Earth Mastery. We have maxed out the Earth Enchantment with Brimstone and Stone Skin and Volatility. 1 point spent on Heat Shield, 1 spent on Stone Form. The Ring of Flame is maxed out, of course, with the Add-on, because this is the main skill of this build anyway. Of course, this 45 physical damage is not a big number, but it gets buffed by other things, like this one plus physical damage. It buffs from other items and skills and whatnot. So it deals more damage, it is not just 45. And this one, of course, the fire damage buff, it gets buffed by other stats and skills and items and whatnot. Here we have a volcanic orb, not maxed out. I don't know if I will max it out at fragmentation. Maybe I will. In Spirit Mastery, we have the Death Ward, maxed out of course. Death Seal Aura will get maxed out later, this one, but this one is already maxed out because this one decreases the armor absorption of enemies that are hit by this aura, which means that enemies now receive even more physical damage, which means they receive even more physical damage by Ring of Flame with the softer metal add-on. And Necrosis, which is maxed out. This, of course, this one helps when we go to deal vitality damage to enemies, which we deal, or life leech, or bleeding. But we don't have any bleeding damage skills, so this one helps with vitality and life. We have maxed out the life drain, vitality damage, the cascade, vitality damage and attack damage convert to health, and Soul Drain, which is again damage to ghosts and vitality damage and whatnot. This build uses all the time the Dark Covenant for the energy regenerate total speed, but mostly for this one, the add-on, because this one provides plus 75% physical damage and plus 75% vitality damage and all of the other stats. But this physical damage, of course, buffs up this one as well. We have maxed out the Spirit Ward Aura and the Spirit Bane. We haven't maxed out this one. It is not necessary to spend more points here, actually. Even this minus 45% recharge is good enough. And the Soul Vortex is maxed out. This is something like a small aura, but it lasts only 4 seconds. But I use it. Now, for the items. This is a legendary hero, by the way. We use the Envy of Set Eternal Embers artifact, which has the skill Abdicate. We use it for this skill Abdicate. This skill is this one up here. As we can see, it is this one. It has a 10 meter radius of effect. It deals some reduction to enemy's health at slower movement, but the reason I use this one is the minus 30% physical resistance. So enemies under this effect receive much more damage from the physical damage of Ring of Flame. And it helps very much. Because we have this combination of armor absorption of enemies, which gets reduced, then we have their physical resistance getting reduced, so this way we buff up the physical damage of all of our sources that deal physical damage anyway in general. But in this case we have mostly Ring of Flame Softer Metal and a little bit this one. So, this is a perfect artifact for this build. Here we have this Mastery Frequent with the Mountaineer's prefix, and I don't remember if it has any suffix. Of regeneration suffix, probably. Or of immortality, something like that, I don't remember. I went with this component because I wanted more energy regen and strength points. Strength, of course, increases physical damage and the damage of Ring of Flame. Here we have the Tracker's Hood. I'm using this one for the recharge reduction. It is 58%. And it helps very much, of course, especially with using this one. This one now has 30 second duration and 33.6 seconds recharge, so we can have it almost all the time running, up and running, almost all the time. So this one is perfect here. We have the Stonebiter's Cuffs of Power only, it doesn't have a prefix, but it is still a perfect item for this build. And I went with Terracotta Plating for resistances. Here we have this item, which is very perfect because if I take it off, my bleeding goes down to minus 90, this one goes down to minus 34, and we lose strength points. With this one on, we get health, more strength for more damage output, and we fix our resistances. Here we have the Aphrodite's Favor, plus 2 to all skills, many health points and resistances. Here we have the Alki, which provides a big amount, a big buff to strength, which we want for being able to equip this item, for example, and also here to help with damage output. Here we have the Resisted Kyklos of the Tinkerer, resistances for survivability only. Here we have this shield, which is very good for this build because it provides a recharge reduction and energy cost reduction. So, on this build we combine energy cost reduction, 55%, with energy regeneration, which is now 68 flat. Some items that provide energy regen. So, yeah, and this also provides energy regen. And I'm using the Touch of Nyx because it provides energy regen again, casting speed, energy cost reduction, and some resistances, nice item. Now I have almost all of my skills activated. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And if I activate the Heat Shield, we have 15% physical resist. This is my armor. These are my resistances. Perfect, good, perfect, good. It is okay because bleeding is not that, you know, important in most places of the game. Poison again the same, it is okay, but in a couple of cases it would be bad anyway. Vitality, anyway. Remember, this is an experimental build and I don't know how well it will work later. It is we are going to do experiments with this one. Secondary. Movement speed, casting speed, resistances and recharges. Defensive is not good for legendary, but we will try to survive. So, more or less, this is the build. Now I will go and kill some enemies so that you can see some gameplay to see how much damage we actually deal. Let's go that way. We will have gameplay now. Activate this one. So, as we can see, in legendary difficulty it is not really... Your aura is not going to destroy enemies very fast. And when it comes to boss fights, we can forget about it. It is not like... unless we can wait 30 minutes to kill a boss. A big boss, at least, by using the auras alone.
No, it's danger.
Of course, what we can do is this one. Auroras will keep attacking and killing enemies if we are under the stone form. I'm not going to get the battle marker. So yeah, as we can see, it is really hard to make an aura build in Titan Quest which will be killing enemies super fast. You know, this game is not like, for example, Diablo 3, where you can have this type of builds much easier. Or Path of Exile, where you can have many crazy builds killing whole screens of enemies with one shot.
The necklace! May the goddess Hera bless you!
But this aura build still works because it deals a good amount of damage in legendary. And if we combine it with a couple of other attacks and spells, then this becomes a complete build. Now, if Ring of Flame could work like, for example, throwing knives or blade barrier or sand power, which those skills utilize flat damage that comes from items, except for weapons, it has that effect that can transmit weapon attacks, weapon effects, not attacks. If this skill was like those ones, we would be talking about a very interesting skill, which actually would be working pretty much fine. But still, this build is working, it is a nice build, it is okay, nothing special, it is not the best build out there. But it is working, and if someone would like to play this way, and also to be using Chuck, and having this thing killing enemies, or even doing this move, chuk chuk chuk, then yeah, it could be very interesting. So guys, this is it for this video. So if you like what you see, stay tuned, subscribe on this channel, and I will see you very soon again. Have a super great day.